Hello everyone, and welcome to the Space Engineer Survival Mode tutorial. I will assume that you have already watched the Space Engineer's Alpha tutorial, and you already know the basics. If not, please watch the Alpha tutorial first. There are many new features and things for this mode, so let's get started. We will start with creating a new custom world. You can choose from different scenarios that will best suit your playstyle. Easy Start 1 contains all what you need to learn about the game's mechanics and systems. Easy Start 2 acts more like a sightseeing map with an asteroid station and spaceships. Lone Survivor offers a very basic station where the player needs to build ships from scratch. Asteroid Scenario places the player into a ship on its way to a new asteroid cluster. Crashed Red Ship sets the player into a position of a crew member that survived from a large collision. Empty World is a scenario with nothing but the player and sun. I'm going to start with the Easy Start 1. Check the Survival Mode. Survival Realism option sets the difficulty level. The higher the number, the easier it is to gain materials and construct ships. For our purposes, I will go with realistic times 10. Decide whether you want to play with your friends or by yourself. Max Objects option is the limit on free floating objects, such as ingots, components, and ore that float in space. This option can help you with optimizing your world. Do not set it to minimum number, since it might be really hard to mine manually. When the limit is reached, the oldest objects get erased. This does not apply for grids like wrecked ships and their parts. Asteroid amount sets the number of asteroid clusters in the world. This option can highly increase the amount of ore for mining, but also keep in mind that it may take longer to load the worlds. The option for auto healing can have a big impact on the difficulty level, since it is possible to heal only in medical rooms. Autosave is helpful for those that don't want to save frequently by themselves. Weapons Enabled is an option that can keep you and your ships safe from weapons. Show Player's Name option helps to recognize players. All the options can be changed later from the Load World screen after clicking the Edit Settings button. But you need to leave the world before applying any changes. In case you would like to make your own scenario, edit the world settings of your old world. Or create a new world in creative mode, build all the structures, and when you are done, change the world settings to realistic mode. Energy. Everything needs energy to work. Ship systems, production systems, and even astronauts' suit. Nuclear reactors need uranium ingots to produce energy. All systems consume energy from the reactors, even the medical room. Energy is the most important thing in the survival mode, because without energy, there are no conditions for life. All energy stats can be visible from the cockpits, even for stations. To save energy, turn off all the systems that are not used at the moment from the control panel. Every cockpit can give you exact information of the time that your reactors will produce energy with current power usage. When leaving a ship, turn off the ship's reactors by pressing Z. Death and respawn. The player can die by falling, collision, being shot, or depleting energy in his suit. When astronaut dies, player loses all items that were stored in astronaut's inventory. Energy in the suit drains based on player's actions. Using tools and jetpack consumes their energy faster than just walking around. The astronaut's suit can be recharged at a medical room or by sitting in any cockpit. Both must be charged by energy from the reactors to be able of recharging the suit. Once the energy in suit reaches zero, jetpack stops working and your health starts to decline. If you are inside a gravity field, there is still a chance you will survive by recharging at the closest medical room. Otherwise, you will float away dying. In the case that you get into a situation with no solution, you can press the backspace key to respawn. This action will cause losing all items stored in astronaut's inventory. Player will spawn at his medical room. In case of multiple medical rooms, the player will spawn in the nearest medical room. The medical room is the only object that belongs to a specific astronaut's ID. This means that the player can spawn only in his own medical rooms. To make sure that there will always be an operational medical room, create a standalone unit with only a reactor and a medical room. In case of permanent death, due to missing spawn points or medical rooms without energy, the player will spawn as a new astronaut in a rescue ship. The rescue ship contains all the devices that you need to survive in space. All the objects created in the past are still in the world. The player will not lose anything unless somebody else takes it. Since the medical rooms hold astronaut's ID, the new astronaut will have to disassemble all the old medical rooms and build new ones. Differences in single-player and multiplayer game. The most important difference from single-player game is that the multiplayer world can change even when you log out as a client. If the server keeps running, the time goes on as if you still were in the game. This means that the assemblers and refineries can continue their production. But also, the energy can be completely depleted, ships can be stolen, and medical rooms destroyed. So be more careful about your economy structure and hangar placement. The system of saving worlds is the same as for the creative mode. Everyone can save the game, but make sure that only the person with the newest save hosts the next game, to prevent data loss. All clients start in the rescue ship. The meeting points and actions that you can do depend on the scenario. Sometimes you can meet on a platform beacon, other times you will have to all agree on a meeting point close to a specific asteroid. Construction in space. To construct something in space, you need to go through a specific process of gaining materials and transforming them into components that are used for the construction of the final object. Go to the assembler, open the control panel, and click the production button. Find the object you want to construct in the blueprint window. Use filters to find the specific item. You can choose anything from a single component to objects like cargo container. Place the cursor above the icon. In the middle window, you can see ingots that you need to produce components for the final construction. If you don't have the required ingots, you need to find the ore on an asteroid and mine it. Mining ore. Ore can be seen as color spots on the asteroid's surface. Each asteroid's core is made out of iron, which makes it easier to find but harder to get. Mining ore manually with the hand drill is more time-consuming but allows you to better explore the asteroids. The hand drill is equipped with a short-range ore detector that will show the type of ore once you get close to it. When mining, hold T to gain some ore right after it's excavated. The rest of the floating ore needs to be caught so it gets stored in the astronaut's inventory. When the astronaut's inventory is full, move the items into a cargo container and continue drilling until you have enough material. Mining with a small ship drill is faster and the material gets stored in the drill's inventory automatically. To see the amount of mined ore, open the terminal screen, go to the inventory and use the filter icon to visualize only the drills. It is possible to use the small ship ore detector to search for ore much easier. The better designs of the mining ship, the better results you get. Refining to ingots. Once you mine enough ore, it's time to refine it into ingots that are needed for the component production. Get close to your refinery and place all the ore into its inventory. The refinery starts refining automatically. Always make sure that you have enough energy and that the refinery is turned on in the control panel. You can see that there are shapes with outlines on the icons. This means that you can insert only a specific type of item. There are more objects that use these filters. If you are playing in offline mode, the game gets paused when you enter a menu screen. All production is paused until you go back in game. That means you have to keep playing and check the control panel every once in a while to see if the production is done. Assembler production. If your assembler is connected to the refinery through an inventory door, the assembler receives the needed ingots for production automatically. If the assembler is not connected, you have to move the refined ingots from the refinery inventory to the assembler inventory by yourself. Open the assembler control panel and click Production. In case you have more assemblers, it is possible to switch between them to select the correct one. Choose the object you want from the blueprint window. The needed components for construction will be added to the production queue automatically. If the amount of ingots is sufficient, the production will go on until all components are assembled. It is possible to repeat the production queue when it reaches its end. For that, click the repeat button. This way, you can focus only on mining, while the assembler takes care of the production. Inventory and control panel buttons will redirect you straight to the specific assembler options, so you don't have to search in the main list. Assembler disassembling mode. All the assembled items and components can be disassembled back to ingots. Set the assembler into disassembling mode by clicking this button. This way, you can recycle any object you don't use anymore or get ingots that are hard to find. It is also possible to set repeat production, so that all items placed in the assembler's inventory gets disassembled automatically. To set the assembler back to the assembling mode, click this button. Construction of an object. When you decide to build a new craft, you start with a landing gear that can be snapped and locked to a surface. This way, you prevent interrupting your small ship construction because of losing it in space. It is possible to start a construction in an open space as well if you want to. To unlock the landing gear, you need to build a cockpit. To construct an object, open the toolbar config screen and place the cursor above an icon. Windows on the left side inform you about the construction requirements and the amount of needed components. Top window for large object, bottom for small ship object. To start the construction, you need at least one construction component that is at the bottom of the component list. Take the components from the assembler or a cargo box and go to the area of construction. If you have enough space in your inventory, take more components. Press G and drag the object to your toolbar. Press 1 and place the block in front of you. Each construction consists from two actions: adding components to stockpile and welding the components together. Think of the construction as adding layers of components to the structure by welding. Each component icon in the list represents a layer that needs to be welded. Take the welding tool and weld the construction for a second. All components that can be used for the construction were moved from astronaut's inventory into the construction stockpile. You can tell by numbers in the construction process window. This way, you can bring all the components first and start with welding later. The list of component layers informs you about the order of construction and amount of components for each layer. Red color may appear while welding. It indicates you don't have enough components to finish the layer you are working on. you cannot continue welding until you add this component to the stockpile. Gray color indicates that there are none or not enough components for the layer to be finished. Blue color means that there is enough specific components in the construction stockpile and welding will not be interrupted. White color indicates finished welded layers. The progress bar informs you about the object's integrity. Integrity serves as health of the object. The more components are welded together, the higher integrity object has. The red line indicates level of functionality. When integrity reaches above this line, the object starts working. If an object has integrity below red line, it's not working and control panel shows it as broken. To see info about any object, you need to hold welder or grinder tools in your hand and look at the specific object. Recycling. In case you don't have any use for an object, use the grinder tool and start disassembling. Disassembling can be done even in the middle of a construction, or to recycle a wrecked ship that you found. Disassembling shares the same layer rules as assembling. You have to go layer by layer to get the wanted components, but this time from top to bottom component layer. Disassembled components go automatically to your astronaut's inventory until it's full. When there is no place in astronaut's inventory, components get stored in construction stockpile. When you empty astronaut's inventory and use grinder tool on the same object, components stored in the stockpile will be moved to astronaut's inventory until it's full. If you need specific items quickly, throw away items from astronaut's inventory to space and continue grinding. Repairing. Damaging an object causes component destruction. When integrity goes below red line, the object stops working and a note is added into the control panel screen. Enter the cockpit and see the control panel. This note informs you about the heavily damaged object. Equip your welder to see the stats and look for the damaged object. The destroyed component layers need to be repaired by placing the missing components and welding. Repairing works the same way as constructing a new object. In case of emergency, you don't have to repair the object to full health. Just repair it to a functional state. Refuel and reload. Once in a while, you will need to refuel your ship or reload the weapons. To refuel a ship, you need to place uranium ingots into a reactor through the inventory door. Try to design your ship in a way that allows you to refuel without bigger problems. The same applies for weapons. The Gatling gun has two inventory doors for reloading ammunition. Rocket launchers need to be loaded by the front. There are no inventory doors. This is all for now. Thank you for watching and we hope that you found this tutorial useful. Now go ahead and try out the survival mode on your own.